We say hello to Chrysa Chin, who is the Executive VP of Strategic Engagement and Development for the NBA Players Association. Thank you so much for dropping by. It's great to meet you. Tell everyone what you do in your job.
So I am EVP of Strategic Engagement and Development, and basically I work with all of our players on different aspects of their lives. So I'm the crisis management person for our team. I oversee our drug and alcohol program. I focus on our iconic initiative, which focuses on players who are under 21 years of age. And I'm on Michelle Roberts' senior management team.
Good stuff.
That is good. You're a boss.
Yes, boss.
I know some of the things you really focus on are the rookies in the NBA and just their transition in terms of the league. What are some of the things you work on with them? How do you give them tools to maybe get through their rookie seasons?
So we have a program. Actually, Purvis Short runs our player programs department, and they focus on the rookie transition program that's delivered jointly with the league. But in addition to that, we have other programming. So we have a rookie enhancement program. There are all types of programming that focuses strictly upon the transition into the NBA. So I think everyone is familiar with the rookie transition program. We have a meeting with our players during that time at our union that talks about what the resources are. We oversee the agents and just deliver all resources that focus solely upon their transition.
Now, before this role, you worked with the league, and I remembered you, Chris, as soon as I saw your name, as the hat lady.
Yes.
From draft night.
You you were still the hat lady, you said. No.
I've heard. They're not bringing me back, though.
Cool, though. But how do you get into this space in terms of athlete development? What has been your trajectory to get here?
So I am in this arena for more than 25 years now, closer to 30 years. I'm not telling my age, and it's my third career. So I majored in international relations at Hobart and William Smith Colleges. When I graduated from school, I was trained as a case manager for the city of New York, and I worked with different populations, juvenile delinquents, the criminally insane and the elderly population, so very different populations. And then I thought I might have wanted to go to law school, so I went the paralegal route, became a case manager, and then thought I wanted to transition into sports. I realized that I didn't want to be a lawyer, but wanted to do something that would help people and just use all of my skill sets. So I interviewed for two different positions. One was a job at Pro-Am, and the other was at the Players Association many, 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 many years ago in the early 90s under a different leadership team. So I got that job. I took it. It was a much smaller operation then, but I developed a lot of relationships and sort of became a point person, really, really focused on the development of those relationships and helping players. Transitioned out of there, did some consulting for Nike in a similar role. And then went to the league. I started at the league with the WNBA actually to help launch that, and then was transferred over to men's basketball, which is where I belong.
I mean, speaking of the WNBA, I know you're familiar with Swin Cash, somebody who's actually worked here, and then Lindsay Gottlieb.
Yep.
I mean, what are some of these new hires with women in the NBA? What do you see? How is that an impact for women in the league? And is it hard for people to grab a hold of that? I mean, do you see that continuing to grow?
I think it's going to grow. I think for some people, you know, it's an older school of thought, so some people are going to have difficulty grasping the concept. I think it's great for both Swin and for Lindsay. I think that people will still see, regardless of gender, what they have the resume and what their skill set is and how it's transferable. I think, you know, I know Swin better, so I know that Swin is going to go in immediately. She's going to make an impact. She's going to be a leader, and I expect the same of Lindsay. And I think that having a seat at the table is really—it's important. She's going to be in a decision-making role, and people are going to have to respect that. And she's going to have to make some hard decisions, as will Lindsay. So we'll see how people respond.
How has the one-and-done rule impacted what you do in your job?
Well, I've seen many things happen. So obviously my career started when players could come directly out of high school into the league. The one and done, you know, the players are still transitioning in very early in their careers if they opt to only do 1 year of college. So it has not changed it. I still have to be focused upon and concerned about the very same things, and that is the limited amount of life experience that some players might have. There's still very difficult decisions that players have to make, whether you're 18 or 19. So whether you have 1 year or not, the decision-making process is still the same. This is a very difficult career path. It's one that players have fought hard to get to, and I'm happy that they're able to. Their talent has allowed them to do that, so it's up to all of us to help deliver that skill set.
Earlier this year, in the spring, as Adam Silver was making various media stops, he said that he's had opportunities to talk with players and discuss some mental health issues in this space in terms of dealing with loneliness and such. Your background, you've dealt with a variety of types of folks. But Chrysa, as you've watched this league grow and we get to 2019, maybe you blame it on social media as well. How have you seen the NBA player sort of shift, or have they shifted at all?
Shifted in which way?
In terms of this idea of like mental health and sensitivity.
They're talking
and all
about
that
it
stuff.
Now, right?
Yeah, they absolutely are talking about it. So I think one of the things that has happened when you have players like DeMar DeRozan and Kevin Love, you know, come out and speak openly about it, it sort of takes away that stigma, and it's okay to get help. I oversee, as I mentioned earlier, the drug and alcohol program, so not necessarily associated with mental health, but I've always encouraged players to get counseling, and I've also been very successful in doing that before it became sort of trending or cool, and it's something that we have focused upon for a very long time, is trying to remove that stigma and make sure that guys get the help that they need, that there is no shame, that it actually is a symbol of strength when you do that. So you do see it, you do see players talking more. I mean, one of the things that we do during our, during many of our outreaches, whether it's our Top 100 camp or whether it's our elite high school initiatives and in our rookie transition program, is we have group breakouts. And those are the more popular sessions when players get to share and talk about exactly what's going on
and how
they're dealing in small groups.
That's awesome.
Now, do you work any differently when someone like Zion Williamson is the number one overall pick? Do you give someone like that any extra attention? Does that change any of your responsibilities when you have a player like that?
He's gotten lots of extra attention.
Yeah,
I think this way. I think every situation is different, and it doesn't matter whether you're projected to go number one or number 60, right? You still have to look at the situations individually, and so that is how I focus my efforts. It's based upon what support is around them, what I think they may need based on my experience, and then I just try to make sure that those resources are there and that they're set up for success.
And you're getting to know them personally.
That's awesome.
So they're all different people. Right?
They're all different people, and so there is no cookie cutter method. I mean, there are some things I think that we all agree that players sort of need, but some, believe it or not, regardless of age, come in with those skill sets.